Namaskar, me Paula McGlynn, ani ha maza ghar. Today we're doing maja Aaichya Hatcha. Because of course my mother is Canadian, this whole episode is gonna be in English, but we will have Marathi caption options, so make sure you click and turn on the captions for Marathi. Yes, chala.
जगभरात कुठेही जा, कितीही फॅन्सी हॉटेलमध्ये खा, शेवटी आईच्या हातचं ते आईच्या हातचंच असतं.
So this is my mother, Christine McGlynn. And this beautiful woman is, well, she's been my mother my whole life.
Amazing that.
And so she's a registered nurse, and she's probably one of the most adventurous people I know. She's a sailor, she's a canoeing person, she hikes, she fights grizzly bears with her bare hands.
Oh, wow. I do go bear spotting though.
Yeah. Whenever we come visiting mom, she has always, she always gives a disclaimer. And by the way, one disclaimer is she just got all of the plumbing redone in the house. So all of this stuff is temporary. And anything you want to say about the plumbing?
No, it's just that the drywaller can't come till after you go home. So yeah, so today we're going to do like a couple of your favorite dishes. Mm-hmm. One being burgers and then some crumble, which is very English originally, I believe.
So what are you doing here?
So I'm just grating some lemon zest.
Smells so good. When you zest a lemon,
yeah,
you don't want to get any of the white stuff, right?
That's right, that's more bitter.
Measuring everything carefully.
One. Two.
So what have we kept in this bowl? We've got brown sugar.
I've got 4 tablespoons of brown sugar, 2 teaspoons of lemon juice, and 1 teaspoon of zest. And then I'm just going to throw this and the strawberries in.
The whole thing?
Yeah.
Geez.
Mm-hmm.
Rhubarb.
So we're going to pour this into a dish, and I'm going to just throw some tapioca in here too. It won't taste very nice. Oh, the strawberries might, but I don't know. I would just put some in to just absorb some of the juices a bit. Okay. I'm just putting a little bit of butter on the dish.
Okay.
And we're going to put this in, and then we're going to make the crust. Okay, so let's do the dressing. Now, why don't you do the topping for it, and then we'll pop it in the oven.
Okay. So, Mom, you were going to tell a story about how I also got in trouble.
Oh, gosh, where do I begin? You, when nobody was looking, you decided to sneak out the back door, and we had the police alerted and everyone, because you had gone for a long walk and ended up on Lonsdale Avenue picking the municipal flowers.
Sugar?
Sure. All the flowers out of the planters that the council had put in. And then they said, we just can't handle her. We were at a park, Stanley Park, which is a big, beautiful park in the city in Vancouver. And Paula was holding my hand and struggling to get out of my hand like this. She was 2. And, you know, in the end, I let her go. And I was just talking to our friends, and I turned around and she was gone. And so we had this big manhunt out, everybody looking for her. And what she'd done is she'd gone about quite a long way, 0.5 kilometer. She'd gone to the aquarium. She'd got herself in under the turnstile, and she was doing the exhibits at the aquarium. She was only 2. And one of the security guards noticed she was just wondering where the parent was for this little girl. We had taken her there many times before, so she knew her way around the aquarium. And
the aquarium.
I know
you
did.
I think it's still my favorite thing to do in Vancouver.
And anyway, so they found her, thank goodness. So that was a real heart-stopping experience. I usually do it with my hands, but hold on a sec. Just make sure we got everything in. I think cinnamon and hazelnuts before you do everything.
Okay.
Things on there, yeah. Out like that. Yeah.
This is like the easiest.
A little bit more, maybe. It's got to be part of the crumble. Did you get the butter? See, the butter needs to be a little bit more crumbly.
Smaller.
Yeah.
Okay,
just really
so
get it between
big.
Your fingers, yeah.
Okay.
It just so you want it coated.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So don't just mix. You have to really
yeah,
crush
you want
it.
To really crush it, a bit like pastry.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's what I do. I
okay.
Between
so
my
I was
fingers.
Doing it all wrong.
But well, we're so busy talking.
But you know, I was really lucky that I got to go and do all of these things, pay through university, go on trips and things, because my mom kind of forced me to do these lifeguarding classes. Like, she's the one who pushed me into it. And even when I wanted to quit, because I quit a lot of things I started when I was younger, which was like a running joke in the family.
Well, yeah, but I don't think.
I ended up finishing all of these classes by the time I was 16.
Yeah.
And got this really great job, which just paid me pretty well, like $20, $21 an hour. Yeah. Which was really good, like 1,000 rupees an hour. Mm-hmm. And because of that, working my way through school and everything, I never accumulated any debt and got to travel and do whatever I
you
wanted.
Did. Yeah. So she was very independent, hence the fact that she was never afraid of being left behind as a child. So, I mean, she was always looking to escape. And my neighbor, I'd say, oh God, we've lost Paula again. And they'd say, she'd say, no, Paula's not lost. It's you guys aren't keeping up. Paula knows exactly where she's going. And she did. And she did that right off to India and never look back. And that's sort of, yeah, very my loss. But I think India's gain.
That's true.
Yeah.
That's enough of that.
Okay.
Shall I put this
yes.
on top?
Yes, that would be lovely. Okay. Perfect. And then we'll pop it in the oven at 375 for about 40 or 50 minutes. And then we'll make the hamburgers.
So these burgers, I have the most strong memory of these burgers in the summertime, being grilled on the barbecue outside. And it was the best smell to come home to, because you come home and we have this big barbecue grill on the balcony. Today we'll be making it on a grill on the stove, but I'd be playing outside and suddenly you can smell the searing meat on the barbecue, and that would just bring me home. I'm salivating right now just thinking about it. So mom's grating some cheddar cheese. That's going to be mixed in with the ground meat.
You can use any kind of ground meat for them, and they're chili cheeseburgers.
Yum.
So you can, you know, if you want to use a lighter meat like chicken, I would just suggest you maybe use a milder cheese, and you might want to adjust the spices accordingly. So if you crack the egg and whisk it up a bit, and then crush a large clove of garlic.
Two large cloves of garlic. Mm-hmm. This is a fun thing called a garlic press. So you put your garlic in and you squeeze. And the garlic comes out like that. So one level teaspoon of chili powder, correct?
Yeah. Okay.
Come
half
on.
Half a teaspoon of cumin.
Cumin, manje, jeera.
Spices,
salt, garlic.
Yeah, salt and pepper, quarter of a cup of breadcrumbs, and just whisk it all up, and then we add the meat and then the cheese, and then we'll make some patties. And I'm going to preheat this.
What is that?
This is breadcrumbs. Cutting in breadcrumbs, and it'll soak up all of that stuff. Hey, what are you doing? Are you doing something without
I'm
telling
just making
us?
Them. Canned custard, you know, it's I just thought I would do it because
just getting a head start on something we don't even know about. So
because
the
you're
custard
done,
is
going
to go with the crumble,
yeah,
and a custard you guys have caramel custard a lot and things. So custard is, yeah, just like the egg.
Bird's eye custard. Sure, you have that
egg,
one.
Egg yolk and milk and sugar cooked together into a like a creamy
thing.
Mess
here.
So we just pour it on top of it at the end.
It's delicious. Yeah. Yeah, so I'm cheating because you can make it yourself with egg yolks. But it's just basically custard powder, which is bird's eye, which is on the counter there. Very common. You can get it anywhere in the world. I just push, lift it up. Sorry, we have a burger, but have to do it like this. Sometimes they stick. Yeah, that's okay. Just enough. And all right, and we can take out the. Great, let's just give them a couple of seconds to heat through.
Yeah, let's bring the pie out.
I think that's pretty good, don't you?
Wow, that looks great.
Or should we do a bit longer?
No, I think that's perfect.
That's good. Okay, slice me a mayo.
Okay.
We'll do it just a little bit.
Smear of mayo on the top. Tad, some mustard.
It's.
Mom's homemade barbecue sauce. I think if this video gets over 10,000 likes, then we'll share the barbecue sauce recipe in the comments or in the description. See? YouTube. Mm-hmm. Is that okay? Yeah. I like to stack it with the light stuff on top. Red onion. Do slice a tomato. And patty. And because I love pickles, I like to put mine on top. Yeah, let's dig in.
Dig in. Looks great.
So I'll show you guys a little cross section.
Listen to that crispy bun. Yeah.
Ooh. Well, look at that.
Juicy, running down your hands. Juicy good.
Yeah. All the oil and stuff is squeezing out from the cheese.
Mm-mm. Good sloppy burgers. Delicious. Strawberry rhubarb crumble. Yum.
Custard on top. It's so good.
I know.
I don't even think I realized that there were hazelnuts in it until I made it with you.
Yeah, really gives it a crispy, more than the crunch. It gives it crunch where the butter makes all the oatmeal crispy, but this gives it crunch as well.
So, as you can probably see by looking around, there's hardly any things to clean up. Food is on the table, it's hot, it's ready. Everything's come out at the same time. And it's all thanks to my mother's experience. And Mom, if you could just do one thing for our fans, put your hand out like this and say Shastra Asta Te.
Shastra Asta Te.
Very good. Well, if you enjoyed this episode, make sure you have liked and shared this video. And if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe to Bhatupa Bharatiya Touring Party. Also, don't forget to make sure you check out Vishay Kohl and Bharatiya Digital Party, Bharipa, and check out our merchandise online with bharipa.themerchbay.com. And please let us know in the comments if you have a favorite mother's recipe which you'd like to see and any special requests for the next episode.